Now, probably one of the most classic love stories of all time has been brought to the big screen for the first time in 65 years. There was a telly version, we remember very well. Pride and Prejudice, the movie, premiered last night in London, and the red carpet was out for its all-star cast.
Yo, mic check. Yeah, here you go. He over here. Yeah, I heard he got that hot new thing. It's called
Switch.
Let's get it going. Vibe to vibe a second. It's a club, girl, while you arrive naked. Hear that how the veteran glide the record. But don't download, go out and buy the record.
Good fun, doesn't it? Well, the beautiful people were out last night and the beautiful people are out this morning. Jackie Brambles was there last night and she joins us now live from one of the locations featured in the movie and looks. You really suit that. I think you look absolutely fantastic. That's great.
I have to say, I feel the part. I feel very genteel this morning. We're at one of the houses that the filming took place at for 3 months, in fact. It's called Longbourn in the film. And of course, this is where the Bennett girls live and this is where they first meet Mr. Darcy. So I thought I'd bring along my own Mr. Darcy. Have a little rest for the moment, Mr. Darcy. Thank you. With either him or a horse and carriage on the budget for this morning, so I opted for a Mr. Darcy. But this is Groombridge Place. It's called Longbourn in the film. It's absolutely beautiful. What was extraordinary about the filming here is quite often in movies, they'll use a fabulous exterior like this, and then they build sets inside studios. But here it was so authentic and so perfect for the film that they actually filmed both on the inside and the outside. It's an absolutely beautiful place. I can't wait to see this movie. I really can't. I think it's going to be great. Who was at the premiere last night? Looked like, from what we saw, just about everybody. Just about everybody was there. You're absolutely right. Of course, Donald Sutherland's been on the show this morning. He was there. I think he got the biggest cheer from the crowds because he's done so many fabulous movies over the years. And he said one of the reasons that he was sort of drawn to this film, even though it was with a first-time director, was just because the director, Joe Wright, was so passionate about the project.
He had so much passion, and passion's the only thing that keeps you from being bored, so I wanted to be a part of his passion.
He's a good guy, isn't he? And I tell you what, everybody's saying that Keira Knightley, this is kind of her coming-of-age movie, if you like. She really shines in this film.
She absolutely does. Her last film, The Jacket, she was spectacular in. That was kind of a weird thriller. This one, she's very suited to this sort of period piece. And it's a much younger feeling Jane Austen type movie, I have to say. She's perfect in the lead role of Lizzie Bennett. And of course, there's a new Mr. Darcy. Move over, Colin Firth. Here's Matthew McFadden, who Keira rates quite highly.
Matthew McFadden is so romantic in the film. He really, really is. I mean, I think the film is really told through Elizabeth Bennet's eyes. So at the beginning, you don't like him too much. And by the end, you're completely and utterly in love with him. And that's perfect.
She is so beautiful, that girl. She really is. Now, Matthew McFadden, is he a good Mr. Darcy? Does he smoulder?
He is dark and brooding. He smoulders non-stop, and you do really quite dislike him, I have to say, at the very beginning. He's a very unassuming guy in real life, though, very pleasant, very mild-mannered, and was a little bit intimidated at the thought of taking on this role.
It's one of those parts. It's one of those iconic parts, so it was a thrill. I'm in good company, you know, with Colin Firth and Laurence Olivier. I think even Peter Cushing played Darcy.
Yeah, and of course Colin Firth, and you know, it's a wonderful, wonderful book, marvellous work of literature, but the question that I think we all want to know is, in this movie, does Mr. Darcy get his britches wet? Does he dive in and come out all damp?
He has very tight britches, I can tell you that, and as he strides across the sort of the moors and things, he looks very, very handsome, but they don't get particularly damp. I do think this is Mr. Darcy for the younger generation, for sort of Keira Knightley's generation. He is perfect. I think for old birds like myself, you can't beat Colin Firth, but Matthew McFadden is a fabulous, young, dashing Mr. Darcy.
Oh, wonderful stuff. I'm really, really looking forward to seeing the movie. I love the TV series.